T-Walks, hit the battlefield and go berserk. 20-inch arms pumping iron till you know it hurt. He looking like he probably fresh out the pen, but nah, he just consistent, young and fresh out the gym.
What's up, it's T-Walk the Hawk. Down here at the home gym right now. About to hit chest, do some fasted cardio. Tired right now. It's like 9 in the morning. Haven't ate yet. And I haven't really been eating like that. So yeah, about to get this workout in today. Again, focusing on chest, and I'm gonna do my cardio afterwards, which is gonna be even more of a killer. As you see, I'm rocking to do what you gotta do. Snap back, gray and black. Just came out with the red, black, and white version. You see the tank. This is the Lakers colorway. I got like 6 different colorways right now. Everybody's supporting, scoring good. Pretty much got somebody in like every state repping, wearing the stuff, promoting it, part of the team. If you want to join the team, just message me on my new Instagram at TWalkDogGear. It's pretty clean. I like all my stuff to look different. I got some new colorways coming out. Same thing, I want them to be a little bit more of a different design. I don't want it to look like anybody else's. But yeah, about to hit chest. Main thing, I'm focusing on upper chest and the split in the middle. So that's my weak part, so therefore I'm gonna do that first. So if you know your upper chest is the weakest, you don't wanna start with just flat bench, start with the incline. That way, if you start with flat, by the time you get the incline, you already burnt out, you're not really gonna be able to target that muscle group. So I need to target upper chest and the inner, so I'm starting with that. I'm gonna start off with incline machine press. And then I'm gonna do close grip hammer press with the dumbbells pressed together to really focus on then the chest. So yeah, that's what I'm gonna start with. Plans for the day. It's a nice day out. I might chill by the pool after this. Who knows, but I really wanna get some stuff done before I head out to my appointments later. I'm in sales, if you don't know. So I be hitting door to door. I got 2 appointments this evening. So the goal is to knock out a bunch of topics. I ain't been really doing the Q&A or the topics on here like I was. At one point I was doing like 7 videos a week. So I'm trying to at least get back to doing like at least 1 or 2 videos every single week consistently. Kind of been throwing up, you know, some edits or clips from my Instagram, IG stories, things like that. So I wanna make sure I'm pumping out these topics. I know I get a lot of questions in my DMs. Again, my Instagram got hacked. The old was at TWalkTalkFitness. Now it's TWalkTheHawkGear, which is the apparel. That's also the website, TWalkTalkGear. I'll put both links in the description, so check those out. But yeah, let's get into it. I know it's recording in the mirror. I figured I'd turn around and talk to y'all for a second. It may not have even been a focus, but I'm keeping it. Fuck it. So yeah, about to hit this chest. I'm talking too much, like always. Any questions, comment below. Make sure to like, subscribe, and as always, do what you gotta do, because it's that simple. T-Walk Talk, let's get into it. I say that to say this, everybody making excuses, talking about the gym in your hometown sucks, or only gym is Planet Fitness, or I don't have a gym, I ain't got money for a gym membership. Like, that's literally an excuse. I literally work out in my home gym, which is pretty nice, but weight only go up to 50 pounds. Got a few things of cardio, got a Smith machine, got a tricep pushdown, and this bench press machine, that's about it. And I still feeling better than I had been. I'm more happy with my physique than I had been back when I had a gym membership. So stop making excuses. Whatever the case may be, you can make it work. If you got to work out from home, you can do that. If you got to work out at the park, you can do that. I don't care if it's winter, if it's summer. Just get it done. Do what you got to do because it's that simple, man. The more you tell yourself you can't do something, or the more you put these mental blocks in your head and keep being negative, the more you're not going to get done, the longer it's going to take you to get to all these goals that you dream about every night and telling everybody, but you're not really working towards it because you're constantly being negative, saying all the reasons why you can't get to that goal, why it's taking so long, instead of just waking up and again, doing what you gotta do, because it really is that simple. Like, this ain't just a phrase. I really live by this, and it's all about your mentality. Stop stopping yourself. That's all I'm gonna do. Stop stopping yourself. Keep pushing forward. I don't care what the case may be, if it's with your job, if it's with school, if it's with your weight loss, if it's with building muscle. Stop saying, oh, I got bad genetics. My metabolism is too fast. I can't gain muscle. I had the same problem. Stop saying, I can't lose weight. I got a slow metabolism, or it runs in my family. That's another excuse. It may run in your family, so you may have to work triple the amount harder. It may run in your family, so you may have to work three times harder, but if you really want to get it done, you'll get it done. So it's about just keep pushing forward, keep moving. It's all mental. Stop stopping yourself and do what you got to do. When it comes to growing mentally, it's just like in the gym. In the gym, what do? You burn yourself out and break down the muscle so it builds back stronger. It's tough. You hate it. When you leave the gym, you're exhausted. It's the same thing mentally. You put yourself in uncomfortable situations. I put myself in situations and training and stuff like that where I'm learning so much. By the time I'm done, I got a crazy migraine. I feel exhausted. All I want to do is lay down. And then you know what? I keep doing that week after week after week. But then the next 3 months, now it's not stressful anymore. It's the same thing. You burn yourself out in the gym. Maybe 80 pounds on a dumbbell press was hard. 3 months later, it's easy. It's nothing to you. Now you can rep out 15 reps like it's nothing. It's the same thing mentally. Train your mind just like you train your body. And that's what it comes down to. That's why I work out really. It's not, I don't plan on competing. I have no desire to compete. It's really about keeping myself strong. Again, I lack confidence growing up. So I want to be confident. I want to feel comfortable in my own skin. So I want to look nice, to be honest with you. So whatever your goal is, you know, it is what it is for me. It's mental. It's all mental, really. And the physical helps my mental. So again, figure out what your goal is, push for it, fight for it, do what you gotta do, because it's that simple, you know. Still hate being around the crowd, but you know what I do? I go around the crowd because I know how uncomfortable I feel. More and more I do it, first time, I'm damn near shaking. 10th time, I'm a little calmer. By the 100th time, it's normal. So it's all about, again, doing what you got to do because it's that simple. Again, it's really about training your mind. I'm telling you, like, coming from me, anybody who really knows me, I've talked about this before on my YouTube channel. So from terrible anxiety to the point if I'm in a crowd of them, I'll pass out. I think I passed out probably 5 times in my life, like literally cracked my head, everything. I'm laughing, it's really not funny. But just think about it. The very first time I ever recorded in the gym, I actually paid a videographer. Shout out to Dip. I paid him to record me, right? I wanted to work out. I'm like, the whole way there, I'm driving to the gym. I got the most motivational music on. I'm like, you can do this, you can do this. Nervous as hell, stomach hurting. We go to the gym and like, had to be like 2 a.m. because I knew it was going to be the least amount of people there. Anyway, he's recording me. The whole time he's recording, I like, got my head down, I'm looking around to see if anybody's walking in the gym. Scared as hell, doing my workout, ain't talked the whole time probably. And I say that to say this, because now I'm in the gym, talking to y'all. Somebody walks in, I'm gonna keep talking. So I went from being scared to death at 2 a.m. when there's literally nobody in the gym but me and the cameraman, to now being open in the gym, I'm actually talking to the camera. I'm doing pretty good at it. If somebody walks in, I'm gonna keep talking. I don't care if they think I look weird. I really don't care. It's really about not caring what people think. And like I always say, train your mind. It's gonna make you a lot more successful in life in anything you do. Whether again, it's your job, career, school, being a mom, being a dad, whatever the case may be, just keep pushing, keep getting better. Just keep getting better, man. Do what you gotta do. Do what you gotta do. It's really that simple. It's tough, but it's simple. So next we're doing dips. We ain't got a dip machine in here, so like I said, you gotta make do with what you got. So I'm using the Smith machine, just raise it up, put some plates on the side, just to add some weight. That way, if I'm using any momentum, it's not gonna flip up and slide all the way down and me break my damn body. So yeah, we're doing dips on here. We'll do 4 sets, shooting for 15. It's the third exercise. Again, you ain't gotta do a bunch of exercises. I'll probably do 4, maybe 5 most today. Now I'm gonna do my cardio. Again, I still have an 8. I'm drinking some carbs right now, and then pump, using that Insane Things from Insane Labs. That's actually my favorite pump supplement I've ever taken, besides Fool as Fuck from 5%. I think I like that better, it actually tastes better also. Not affiliated with them or anything, I bought myself. But yeah, mess with it, give it a try. Makes me feel good, especially on an empty stomach. So on these, if you're doing dips for chest, you want your hands wider, closer you got, keep your elbows in, that's for triceps. So if you want to target the chest, elbows out, hands wider. If you want to hit triceps, hands closer, keep those elbows in. So again, today's chest day, I had a tricep yesterday, so that's going to make this even harder. But let's push through, let's get it. Spaced out. I'm about to hit this 20 minutes on the elliptical. Make sure to subscribe, like, comment. Let me know if you want more videos like this where I'm talking to y'all while I'm working out. Or let me know what y'all want. And as always, do what you gotta do, because it's that simple. T-Walk the Hawk.